Welcome, welcome, welcome. We're going to be doing one of my famous two kits in one video, having all kinds of fun in 2022. These are going to be new reissues from the folks at MPC via Round 2 Models sent over. They've got the Monopoly license, so they're going to be doing a lot of fun caricature kits. These aren't super accurate scale models. They are 100% fun and 100% unrealistic, and that's what makes them awesome. You can see the cool box art on this one. It is the custom Willys panel van in the Monopoly livery. So we'll take a look. These are all press fit kits. They come with really sweet decals in the box. We're gonna crack open the Jailbreaker first. Based on Monopoly theme, we're gonna see what's in the box. In this one, we've got a sweet set of decals. We got in jail, go to jail, just visiting. We got all these logos here. We've got community chest logos, Monopoly money, the Monopoly logo. We can decorate this Willys any way we want. We don't have to use the Monopoly decals just because they're in the box. We could go with a total custom paint job and do whatever, but I like the Monopoly theme, so that's what I will be sticking with. Molded in two colors and with chrome parts. You can see here in black, we've got the giant tires. They are plastic, but check out the molding on them. We can assemble those. We could even paint them with a flat coat so they look more realistic than shiny plastic, but they do look just fine if you just want to press fit a kit together and have a nice time. These will work lovely just for some slump breakers for fun. We got the nice chassis here, one large piece. We got our front wheels. The rear wheels look awesome. We've got our engine block halves. We've got headers. Definitely gonna have to get some tones on that header, paint that block. We got our front, so we got our rear suspension, axle, parachute. Looks like we got some axles here. Nice looking. We've got yellow parts. We've got intake, I think, is what this is, the halves of the intake. We've got an interior tub. We've got mystery parts here that I didn't see mentioned in the manual. It looks like a skateboard to me, in that at one time there was a figure that would have maybe pushed onto this. I'm just guessing. So maybe we'll put that skateboard together just for fun, slap a Monopoly sticker on it, have fun with it. But it's not mentioned in the manual. That doesn't mean we can't have fun with it. It's free parts. The Willys panel van, that looks pretty cool. That's what, 32nd scale? Maybe even a little smaller. Nice looking rig. We can definitely decorate that and have a nice time with it. Nice lines. Nice. The panel vans are always cool looking. You can do such cool looks. And then a big honking chrome tree. Check out those rear wheels. The front wheels are going to benefit from a wash. We got valve covers on there. Are those like a 427 valve cover? I don't know. The engine experts will tell. It doesn't need to be real because it's a big model. We got big, big carburetors. Carburetors. Look at the size of those things. Sucking low-flying birds. We got track bars, shifter, intake. We got the big stacks for intake. We got some cool parts. We got our front suspension, looks like there. Yeah, we got some awesome chrome parts. That's it. That's all that's in the box. That's all you need to have a good time. I will see you when we crack open the next one. And now for something completely different. A caricature for the Reading Railroad Monopoly kit. It's a locomotive, but with street tires and a locomotive front end. So this thing is pretty boss. This is definitely the kind of stuff that I am into because it's just so out there. I mean, it's got this giant tank hanging off with the wheelie bar. It's got the huge steam arms, but then it's got a V8 in the, it's weird. It's like steam, gas, alcohol, I don't know, it's so, I'm going to be putting it together because I think that is just so unique and different. So let's take a look at what's going to be in the box when you get yours. As always, I will link down below where you can get these on order. Check out the wheels on that thing. The headers on this one are all put together for you. We got cool valve covers here. We got what looks like the tank top to that alcohol tank in the back, the fuel tank in the back. We got a big chrome piece maybe for the back of the boiler. I love it. Finding out later what stuff is so cool to me. These look like the pistons for the steam part of the engine, where they ride in there and push the arms back. Yeah, where they ride in there and push those arms back and go chugga chugga woo woo. So we've got two colors of plastic in this one as well. We've got black for the tires. Nice tread, just like the Jailbreaker. We got some hubs there. These are the wheels for the front of the train. Those will look nice. No brand names on the tires. Don't need them. We got the big honking smokestack and boiler body, begging for some decoration. We got a big old headlight on there. Two pieces. We've got another tank here. Halves. We got what looks like an axle. I do not know what those parts are, but clearly we are going to find out. That's why we build the model. And in charcoal, metallic. Yes, it's a metallic you can see in person. It's got a sheen to it. You can see the little shiny bits in there. We've got the frame for the train and the cow catcher on the front there. You can see where the wheels will mount up. Everything will bolt on there. It's beautiful looking plastic. I'd like to see a car body done in that round too. Find a cool car to do in that charcoal colored plastic. That's awesome. Got the nice tank here. Engine halves. The steam arms. The driving arms for the wheels. And whatever this mystery mount part is. Gonna find out what it is later. Looks like we got some sort of a belt drive and tensioner. We got the wheelie bar for underneath the tank. I can see what that is. And then we've got the sweet cab. Look at that. Nice detail on there. Window got for the nameplate. We can put a decal on there for the railroad. We got the inside. Open top. Nice looking. You can really get a good look at that metallic plastic. Shiny, that's cool. And then this one has a decal sheet as well. It's even bigger, full of Monopoly stuff. We got all four of the railroads. The B&O, the Body Older Railroad. You always made fun of someone when they landed on B.O. Railroad. And then they've got all the lines listed for the side of the cab. We got the Monopoly money. We got engine numbers. We got Monopoly logos. We got more of the jail. We got a free parking and a go. We got community chests on this one too, and the chance cards. So beautiful decal sheet for this one. I'm going to get to assembling both of mine, the reading and the Jailbreaker. We'll be back before I throw paint at them. I'm going to go over the parts for each vehicle individually so you can see the differences between the two and know what I'll be working on for each one. On the Willys, we've got the block halves. We won't be putting those together, the upper and lower, because you have to capture the headers when you assemble them in between the two pieces. So it would make no sense to push them together now, only to have to try to pry them apart and ruin the paint and get those headers in. So I've got the headers assembled. This one was a little loose. I used some glue on some of these parts if they seemed a little loose from the snap fit. They probably would have stayed together once captured, but since I want to be painting stuff and having a good time with it, we'll make sure if we need to glue stuff, we will. So we've got those parts there that are ready to paint, and the headers look very nice. They self-align. We'll be able to put the chrome exhaust outlet on there when we get to that point. On this tree here, we've got the main chassis. We've got the tires that I have pressed together. No glue required on those. They fit together nicely. I lined up the tread pattern and they look fine. Then we will be able to put our nice chrome wheels in there as we go. On this tree here, the only assembly that was required was to push the differential together. We'll get paint on all that and then we can press that into its final assembly. On this tree, we've got the interior. We've got the upper part of the engine, the intake part of the engine that will have the nice big carburetor sitting on top of it. Those are not glued together. You can press each piece into the upper block when you're done, but I glued them together so I can get it painted as one seamless part, and then I push the wheels on, which is clearly a skateboard. I'll see about painting that up, but at least you can see it together. The interior, excuse me, very basic. we will get that painted up when we do the black halves and then cut it free. So that is pretty much all that is there. If you choose, you can also cut off the carburetors, get those painted up, and I still may do that to give us a little non-chrome action since we've got those velocity stacks to go on the top that are super chrome as it is. The rest of that chrome stuff will be blackwashed as needed. On the locomotive now, I've got the wheels of the tires pressed together. Those I did use glue because normally they would be held together with the chrome wheels, but I do want to paint these to remove the plastic shininess of the black plastic, and I want to get all these painted together, so I did glue those together, and the nice railroad wheels will push in at a later point, but those look nice. Just make sure you line up the tread pattern so that they look a little better, and then I ran some glue right around the seam. They look fine. The rest of the stuff is super, super simple. We have the rear axle for the locomotive right here. The plastic axle will slide through and then join with that wheel and tire set. I'm not going to bother painting this. It's completely underneath the vehicle. We're not going to see it once it's in place, but that's how it goes together. Each axle have, I thought this was a tank when we saw the two parts. It's actually just the axle halves that push together. The block is all one piece. They want you to paint that all one color, and I will do so. I'm going to match the box art within reason. So I push those pieces together, put the intake on, and then ran some glue just to make sure they didn't fall apart while I was moving them around and painting them and all that stuff, but no glue really is required. This is a belt and pulley system, so I will be getting that painted and then accent the pulleys. Then we can press fit that on later. The wheelie bar and the drive bars all request a metallic color, so those will get painted together. The headlight is just gently press fit together, because after I get this painted the blue color that they request on the box art and in the manual, I will then need to put in the lens. So I don't want to glue those parts together, or I'll never get that lens in there the right way. So I can paint this, gently pry it a little bit apart, push the lens in there, push it back together. More than good enough for government work. The frame here I want to paint different than that charcoal color. The only thing pretty much that I'm leaving the charcoal color is the cab and this little mount here for the front of the engine. So those are the only parts I'm going to leave in that charcoal color. This will get painted up a nice black tone. So will the smokestack, and then we'll accentuate the rings upper and lower with hand painting. Got the fuel tank together. They call for that to be an orange color, so that's what I will do with that. And then we have the bell, and on the illustrations on the box, that is a red color. So I will get painted a red color. That is it. That's as easy as this is going to be. The hardest thing I will have to do is run masking tape around the body so I can get the roof of the Willys painted white. That is it. The rest of the stuff will just get painted, which I'm going to go do right now. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
As always, I love character kits. I love how wacky and goofy and different they are because I'm wacky and goofy and different, and I know how to have a good time. It's cool that Round 2 Models has a hold of the Monopoly license now, so they can reissue these old character kits and they can put a new spin to them. Check it out. I even did the skateboard in an old wood grain style skateboard deck with the Monopoly logo, like they handed it out at the stores or something like that when you bought the game. We've got the Reading Railroad locomotive. You can do one of the four railroads on the Monopoly game. We've got the Jailbreaker, so I made sure to keep everything of all the available decals on the sheet. I kept them all within the jail theme. The community chest, go to jail, the go to jail board pieces, the in-jail board piece, it said just visiting around the bottom, but I cut that off. I wanted to say in-jail, and then the chance, go directly to jail on the other side. The chance logos on the tank of the railroad car, or the Reading Railroad locomotive. I use the railroad ones on there, use the Reading name, put the Monopoly logo on, put the $500 bill on there because of the orange accents. I wanted that on the lantern, and then use the Reading Railroad logo just behind the cow catcher. Doing the parts in metallic paints looks awesome. Painted those tires up to look more like real rubber with that super dark gray primer, and these came out beautifully. And of course, the kits are going to look cool on display. So as far as I know, I think there's one more in the series. Maybe there's a couple more. Round two would know. I don't have any insight, but I have the other one that I did, and when they're all released, we'll put them all on the table for a really cool picture in that final build video, and I'll post it on the Facebook page. I love building these. I got both kits done, even with the custom painting and the decaling, and then I future floor polished the plastic and the painted parts and the metallic parts to make them really shine on these. I didn't weather any of these up. I did them nice, shiny, and new. That's kind of my idea for the whole series, so we'll see what I decide as I go. It only took, 2 days of work. First day was assembling and painting, and then the main spray painting, like the masking of the body and the engine blocks and stuff like that. Second day is doing the detail painting and the decals and pushing them together, like you saw in that part of the video where I covered everything from the detail painting, the push assembly, and the final decaling of all the different parts. Nothing but a good time, and you will have nothing but a good time when you pick up the Reading Railroad, the Jailbreaker, the MPC kits, the press fit kits. If you know what these kits were originally before they were Monopoly kits, post down in the comments. I want to know. I like knowing the history of some of them. I don't worry about it. I don't get too precise, but it's kind of neat knowing where these came from and how they originated, and then they turned them into Monopoly themed kits and therefore. So I enjoy it all. As always, remember, this is just a hobby. These kind of kits are here to remind us of that we're supposed to be having fun, enjoying ourselves, not sweating too much of the details, because we should just be smiling and building for ourselves. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see all of you at the next review. We'll be right back.